Hello, friends. My name is Cody DeArkland, and I look after developer relations here at LaunchDarkly. As people start exploring LaunchDarkly and getting started with feature flags and feature management as a whole, one of the most common things that comes up is how do we manage our feature flags from a lifecycle perspective? It's great when we go into code and start building out feature flags to gate out different features or implement targeting rules around different components. But what about when we start to want to have visibility into our entire project and where the flags live, things that need to be removed out when they're done, or even things that become long-lived? Code references is one of our favorite ways to help with that problem and give you a way to have visibility from within the LaunchDarkly portal into your code and see where feature flags are currently implemented so that you can manage them long-term. In this video, I'm going to take you through very quickly how to get started using code references and what it looks like. Let's get into it. On the screen, you'll see I'm inside of LaunchDarkly right now, and I'm inside of my default project with a couple of feature flags for the application that I'm using. Just a quick glance at the application. It's a very basic demo application that I use for just simple walkthroughs. If I go into these feature flags, we can see a number of different tabs up here that are different management aspects of this feature flag. We have this code references tab here that's currently blank. We're going to go through now setting this up very quickly. I'm going to go into the account settings screen and into authorization, and I'm going to create a new API token. I need this token in order for GitHub Actions to connect back to LaunchDarkly and push the code references in. It's important to note that we can do this against a number of different Git repos or even without a Git repo entirely, just from the command line. I'm doing this in GitHub for just a simple demo. We're going to call this code refs. And I'm going to make this an admin token. Ultimately, you should create a role that has isolated permissions just for what you want to do. But just for simplicity, I'm going to use the admin token. I'll be invalidating it after this demo anyways. Here's our API token. I'm going to go ahead and copy that, and I'm going to pop into GitHub now and into the settings screen where I can create a secret. This secret is going to be how we authenticate the GitHub action back to LaunchDarkly to push that data in. So I'm going to go new repository secret. I'm going to call it LD access token and paste that secret in. So that secret's created now, and I can go ahead and move into the actual code and create our GitHub action. I'm going to create a new folder called .github. And just for organization's sake, I'm going to create a folder called workflows. I'm going to create a new file. We'll call it actions.yaml. And we'll paste that in. And what this workflow is going to do is every time I commit code into this repo, it's going to run this action, which is going to gather up our code references and push it into LaunchDarkly. Now, because this is a React project, there's one more small task I have to do. I'm going to create another new folder. We're going to call it .launchdarkly. We'll call it coderefs.yaml. And this is going to have some explicit configurations that I want to apply to my specific project. I need to feed it in the project key, which is just the name of the project or just the key identifier. And what I'm doing is I'm isolating this down to only run against a source directory. I have a Terraform manifest in here, and I don't want to capture the code references from within that Terraform manifest. I only want to capture it from within the actual code of my project itself. And then I have it set up to identify camel case within the React project. And this is a necessary step for React. So I need to go ahead and grab the key. So I'm going to switch back into the portal real quick. Now I'm in my default project here, but I could come in here into my projects, look through, and see all of the keys. That's the gray one on the bottom. So in this case, I'm going to grab just the default project, paste that in, and save. So I have my files completed now. They're all ready to go for the GitHub action. So I'm going to switch back into my command line. I'm going to go git add.github, git add.launchdarkly. I'm going to go ahead and commit that code in. You can see I've demoed this before. And I'm going to go ahead and push this code in. Now that's pushed into GitHub. And if we switch into GitHub very quickly, head into our action screen, we can see that code refs workflow currently running. And if we drop into it, we can actually take a look at the status of it running live. Now that action takes about 30 to 45 seconds to run, so I went ahead and skipped over that for the purposes of this video. But what it's doing is it's going through the repo and looking for any references to feature flags that have been created in LaunchDarkly and pushing them into the portal. So we're going to drop back into the LaunchDarkly UI now and see what that looks like after that GitHub action completes running. So here we are back in the LaunchDarkly UI, and I'm in that feature flag that I was in before for the login screen. If I go over here to code references now, we can see that I'm getting the code reference in for this actual feature flag. So within the src/app.jsx file, here is the feature flags that are being used, and here's the evaluation statement. Now, if I pop back out and take a look at this other feature flag that I have, the new UI one, I can see the same thing for that new UI feature flag. Code references are a great way to get better visibility into the actual code you've deployed and where LaunchDarkly feature flags live within that code. They can help for lifecycle tasks as well as for team onboarding tasks to help them understand how you're using feature flags throughout your application. Do you want to learn more about things like code references and the other features of LaunchDarkly? You should check out LaunchDarkly Academy. It's our new training site that takes you through all of the ways that you can use LaunchDarkly to do great and incredible things within your software. Make sure you subscribe to our channel on YouTube. Have a great day.